Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Building a Better South. We're here in Norton Commons at the Fine Homebuilding House. We've got Gretchen along.
Hello.
And we're going to take you guys, give you a little update on the progress, show you some insulation, and then we'll walk you around the outside, show you a little progress out there. So yeah. We're standing in the flex room.
Right.
Have you decided what we're putting in this space yet?
Well, we've been working with the girls at Our House Furniture, and we're kind of coming up with some ideas of how we're going to style this room.
Okay. So if you guys remember, this is flex room. We've kind of designed it so it could be really a myriad of different options. But let's look at our windows. Now that they're kind of surrounded with insulation, it helps frame in the room. I kind of just want to run and jump in that.
No, it's like a big snow pile of insulation.
So a little bit of details for you guys. So we use a non-expanding foam around the windows that helps seal that in. And then this is a open cell. It's an isonine product. It's a spray foam application that goes in here. And so when they spray it on the walls, it actually comes out because it is such a high expansive foam. You know, I don't know what the ratio is, but it's a lot from when it sprays on. And that's why we can't use that around the windows. It would compress it too much. You wouldn't be able to open up those windows. So the guys will come back in and see behind me, they're shaving off that insulation. So it is flush, and we did fill that cavity complete with that isonine insulation. So you'll get like an R15 insulation factor. That combined with we've got that R sheathing, the zip sheathing with that built-in half inch of insulation on the outside.
Yeah.
It's gonna feel just like Edgewood.
No.
Do we not use this application at Edgewood?
When we opened a wall and we could, we would spray it. But we did not open every wall at Edgewood, unfortunately.
Yeah. So those living in an older home like us, where ours is 150 years old, single pane windows, double hungs. I mean, we can feel that draftiness coming right through.
Yeah.
So that's what we want to prevent when we build our new construction houses like this. And we've taken every precaution necessary with this house, with the advanced building materials and framing techniques to do this. So whoever purchased this home will be very lucky and very comfortable.
Yes.
And then, you know, these are double paned. We use those Windsor windows. So they're filled with argon gas. So that insulation factor is mighty hefty.
Awesome.
So maybe we can take a look around, see if we can find some bigger piles of insulation and want to check on our sliding doors, see how they're looking out there and how this kitchen space is shaping up.
All right, let's go.
Come on, guys. All right, let's go check out those doors.
Yeah. Well, first let's stop and just tell everybody
what are we doing
about this space here.
Oh, we've kind of neglected the little nook here.
Yeah, so this will be the little breakfast nook in the kitchen area. So as you can see, we have the electricians. They wired for sconces on either side. So I'm not going to do a hanging light. We're going to have sconce lights and recess lights. So the plan is here that we are going to build out a banquette area with some beautiful little cushions to sit on. And then we'll put a nice dining table here, which will be perfect for the kitchen. Just add some additional seating inside the kitchen besides the island.
Yeah, and I think you could get 6 to 8 people in this spot, and that's why that front room, we've elected to have it a flex room, so you can do, you know, office or whatever. So, are you thinking maybe we trim this thing out here and showcase some trim work?
Maybe trim, but I'm kind of leaning towards putting some wallpaper in here so that we would wallpaper the nook and then have some Roman shades on the windows that is complementary fabric to the wallpaper. So it really just kind of feels like its own special little space.
Ah, I like it.
You guys stay tuned to see how this space gets designed out.
I just want to like touch the insulation. It's so much fun, but you know, since the guys are taking it down, and if you're ever walking through a house, touch the insulation on the ground. Don't poke the holes in the wall because that's going to impact your insulation value.
Yeah.
But
it's really light.
The best is when maybe they can hand me over the spray gun and we can make some animals. No, I'm teasing. So we got the breakfast nook right here. I think this is where the meals, kids doing homework, I envision that whole space taken on right here, and then you're open to the family room.
Right.
And big TV over the fireplace?
No. I mean, we did wire for it if someone would like it, but we will not be styling it that way.
Will we even have a TV for the show? Probably not.
Probably not, but it is wired. We do have the capability to put a TV in the family room area.
Do people even watch TV anymore? Just stare at their phones or what? So.
I hope so. They're not going to watch our show.
Oh, that's right.
Not
watching TV. Maybe they're watching it on their phone. So.
That's right. Or iPad.
So I want to show you guys one thing too that we did. So this house, it has about 3,500 square feet, and we did do geothermal heating and cooling, but the geothermal systems come a little bit larger, so we just needed one system for this house. But instead of, you know, just doing one system, we put a zone system, so we can have a thermostat in the basement on the first floor and the second floor, so you can regulate that temperature on each floor. But in order to do that, we've got to find a way to get the ductwork from the basement upstairs.
Which AKA means an eyesore for a designer like me.
Gretchen cringed when I told her this. But we had a couple different options, but we ended up bringing this trunk line up right here. And kind of what we're thinking is we're gonna frame it out here and then maybe frame it out there and either do a built-in or maybe desk, furniture, something in here.
Yeah. That's the plan. So it's my job to make this eyesore look like it was meaningful and had a purpose in the space.
Maybe a mural or something?
I don't know. I'm working on it.
Well, speaking of the basement, I know we alluded to showing you guys that in the past. We haven't been down there. I think we finally have some lights down there and maybe give you a little peek of the entertainment mecca that's going to take place down there.
Yeah, the man cave.
Let's go. You might have to watch your steps. They're just shaving some foam down. So.
All right. Maybe I'll just let you guys go.
Well, I'm glad he stopped the footage so he didn't catch me rolling down the steps there.
Yeah. Yes. That's so nice of him.
So in Kentucky, we do basements on all of our houses. It's a 9-inch thick concrete wall, which, you know, a lot of people think that, I think we talked about this in a previous episode, 9 inches thick of concrete. It's like a single pane window, so an R1 insulation factor, so not good.
Yeah.
So we've taken the same isonine spray foam that's upstairs, but this is closed cell, so it doesn't expand as much. It's a much denser foam, so you don't have to spray it as thick. It's like spraying concrete, so it adheres to everything, doesn't quite expand as much, so very solid. You don't want to be cutting through this, so you want to make sure you got everything just right before you insulate in here. So it's really going to help that comfort.
Yes.
And now you do remember we did add this isonine closed cell at Edgewood in the basement. So that has helped a little bit.
Oh yeah, it's warm in the basement at Edgewood.
So by having that separate thermostat down here, you'll be able to control and moderate the temperature here.
Which is nice.
And one thing, I like to be very thoughtful, and I know you do too, when we're designing these basement spaces, a lot of times the heat and air guys sometimes don't think about the finished product in a basement.
Right.
And
the quickest point from A to B.
Had we not intervened on this house, they would have had a 4-foot wide double trunk line going through almost the center of this basement ceiling.
And we're not going for industrial feel in the basement down here.
Yeah, so I'm like, guys, I think we can rethink that.
Yes.
And so we split off the trunk line. So we've got one side of it we held on this wall, and then we also kind of curved it around and put the other on the other side. So what I'm thinking is we'll tray the ceiling.
Right.
It'll look intentional,
right,
but we're actually hiding the ductwork. So
you're
I think it's
going to
turn
like
out
that.
Pretty good. And then if you see, we've wired for a projector screen in the ceiling.
Of course we have.
Surround sound in here. That is going to be the bar, kind of maybe a rich, moody color scheme of some sort.
Some type of wood stain.
Yeah. So I guess as you come around, we'll have a nice little island here. So when you're standing back here, you'll have dead on view of the big projector screen.
What every girl dreams of.
But hey, you know, we thought of you too. We're going to put some brickwork on that whole wall back there as you come down the steps.
Yes, no, I like that. I love adding those architectural interesting details.
Yeah, so I'll add that coziness. We put some can lights in here, speakers, and...
It'll be a great space.
Yeah, so behind us there's also, there's a full bedroom, full bath, storage, the geothermal room. We've got the electrical panel back there. And then one other thing I did want to show you. So instead of having a subwoofer sitting in the middle of the floor, like some homes have.
Yes.
We've actually gotten one. It's about 4 foot tall and tucked it into the wall. So when you are watching those movies, you get that cinematic sound and you get that bass rumbling, which I know you can't watch a movie without the bass going.
I know. It makes it such a better movie, though. It really does.
All right. Enough down here?
Yeah.
Gives you guys just a little touch. We do have power to the house now, so we do have an electric meter on the house, so we're able to get lighting down here in the basement, which is
nice.
Pretty cool before drywall.
Yeah, this is the first time I've really seen it with the lights on down here. So.
No changes.
Yeah, no changes.
So anyway, guys, that's a quick little update here at the Fine Home Building House. If you want to see more, you can always follow Gretchen, get behind the scenes footage of her trudging through the basement and picking through the foam.
Yes.
How can they find you?
You can find me on Instagram under Gretchen Black.
And then you can always find me, Jason Black, with Artisan Signature Homes. And together,
we're building a better South.